Hey guys, and welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, we are Ross, Laura, Joshua, and Noah. And on a normal day, we're sailing around the Greek islands, documenting our travels along the way.
In this final episode of our Thailand vlogs, we show you some of the best sights, beaches, and attractions here in Phuket. No travel experience is complete without some trials along the way, but no one ever grows inside their comfort zone. Leave us a comment and enjoy the show. Don't be fooled that our trip to Thailand didn't go without its drama. We all took our turns getting sick, but it was Noah that was hit the hardest.
You're not very well, are you, Noah?
He's got a bug. Let's hope it's not a bad one.
I began my moped experience petrified.
Turn your indicator off! Go on, lean on your right foot. Faster, faster.
We've just ridden the bikes up to this beautiful viewpoint, and Ross has gone off to check out the way down to the beach, but we've just got the mopeds up here, and it's the furthest I've driven one in both 10 years, but also in the last sort of 2 or 3 days since we've had them, and there may or may not have been utterings of, I'm never doing this again. I'm responsible for this one and not just myself, and for some reason it's getting in my brain. But if we want to go anywhere, I need to man up.
When you look at Thailand, it is just so gorgeous.
You're going to get there by boat.
Oh, so we're not going there then?
There's guards at the entrance. There's something going on with the government, so at the minute it's only by boat.
Oh, so then we need to bring the boat. It's a sign! How does it do that?
When you get then, Josh? But with the help of a patient Ross.
Oh my God, we're going up a big hill. A very, very, very big hill.
Fantastic road surfaces. And awe-inspiring viewpoints to visit. Each time I hopped back on, my confidence grew.
We made it. So you might be wondering why. I have a walking stick.
On a visit to the beach one day, we were on our way for a little jam when I fell from a boulder and fractured my foot. But at least we made friends, and it didn't stop us from still having fun. Or for me making it to the gym.
I'm a sucker for punishment, aren't I?
I know a lot of people out there are going to be worrying, and they're going to say, Laura, don't go to the gym.
Go to the f***ing gym.
The main thing is, the rest of my body still works. All joking aside, I've been an online health and fitness coach for many years. At one point, was a national champion bikini competitor, all whilst managing an autoimmune condition. So working around my own adversity is second nature. I still coach actively from Holly Blue and have clients from all corners of the world who benefit from my nature meets science-based approach. If you're interested in making your own lifestyle changes or perhaps learning how to adapt to your environment, then head to the BoatFit section of our website and join my waiting list. This brings me beautifully onto our partnership for today's video, AG1. Back on board Holly Blue, my coaching skills come in pretty handy as it falls to me to keep everybody on board fit and healthy. Something that I'm pretty strict about is having a micro morning habit of drinking our AG1 nutritional drink before we even touch the pancakes.
So I go healthy, you know?
This is quite a big weight off my shoulders as a wife and a mum, because whether we touch land and manage to provision veggies or fruit or not, it means that our nutritional needs are supported.
Amazing.
AG1 is fantastic for gut health, immunities, and general well-being.
That is so good.
It has 75 different vitamins and minerals, and they're suitable for just about anybody. I really love its taste because it has a very smooth texture and is kind of sweet, which satisfies my sweet tooth. And that makes it perfect for the boys, because although Josh will try anything, Noah is a little bit more fussy.
Will you have one?
No, I'm not having that.
Of course, you all know that other than being a busy mum, I'm also very passionate about fitness, and I have fibromyalgia. One of the main symptoms is fatigue. I drink AG1 for its energizing benefits. Also, it supports my gut health, which is imperative to my overall well-being. If you happen to be traveling or busy, then they do also have these really handy little sachets that you can take and use anytime, anywhere. And don't worry, if you have dietary requirements, AG1 is completely vegan, free from allergens, and has no unnatural additives. If you're keen to try it out, follow the link in the description box below and you can get a free 1 year supply of vitamin D3 and K2 and 5 AG1 travel packs, completely free with your first purchase. You can't put a price on your health. If you're into living a healthy lifestyle at home or away, Phuket has a lot to offer. There are great gyms in most areas and kids are usually welcomed. If you're less into the gym, you can find an opportunity to train on the beach or run at first morning light. There is, of course, all the pristine swimming and snorkeling you can dream of. And if you're into mixed martial arts, there are camps and clubs scattered all over the island. Last but not least, you can simply maintain your fitness in one of the multitude of free outdoor gyms. See, you exercise anywhere here. Phuket is blessed with some world-class beaches, and our favourites north to south were Surin Beach. This beach has glorious turquoise water and pale yellow sands with market stalls running parallel to the beach. This is a great place to swim and shop without any major expense, as the street food and drinks are affordable. Kamala Beach. Kamala Beach is a perfect all-rounder. Not only is it family-friendly, but adult-only areas can also be found. There are plenty of restaurants, shops, and water sports available, all scattered up and down the huge beach, leaving plenty of untouched spaces to sunbathe and relax. We particularly love the northern end for its clearer waters and breathtaking scenery. If you're flush enough for cash to afford staying here, you can easily grab yourself a little slice of heaven. Otherwise, it's easy enough to bike over once you know the cheeky back routes. Kata Noi. Considered one of the 10 most stunning beaches in the world.
How nice is this?
This is absolutely stunning. Oh, I haven't seen a beach like this, even on Greece.
Kata Noi Beach is a lovely sandy bay and an alternative spot if you want to be near the famous Qatar Beach while staying away from the tourist crowds. The water is blue, clear and shallow, and the beach is vast with soft white sand. Nai Han. Nai Han Beach is a long and lazy beach with superb water quality. It's flanked on both sides by jungle and palm-covered mountains and has a laid-back vibe. The food is delicious, and you can shade from the scorching sun under a cooling beachside forest. Ya Nui. A personal favourite, Ya Nui is a small piece of perfection. A charming tiny bay tucked in a cove between the windmill viewpoint and the famous Prom Thep Cape in the very south of Phuket Island. It looks like a secret beach, but it is very well known and gets busy. So go there early enough to grab a good spot. Rawai. Rawai has a rugged Thai vibe of its own. Longtail boats scatter its entire length, and it's a great place to grab a trip to neighboring islands, either from the beach or the pier. It's also a beautiful spot to catch the sunrise, watch sailing and motorboats cruise past, and relax without many tourists about. It's not ideal for swimming, but makes a nice change from the usual hotspots. And every weekend, there is a brilliant market running all along its southern end. Even in the most transient of lifestyles, it's easy to fall into a pattern of the same old, same old. But whether it's location, food, activities.
That is Josh, Ross and Noah out on a triple jet ski.
While I am gonna enjoy the break.
Adrenaline junkies.
Or even how you travel. Variety is the spice of life, and trying new things can help to re-inspire, re-energize, and give a whole new perspective on life. One of our personal favourite ways to change things up is through our love of food.
Got Josh a present. It's a Whopper. He's been dying to try one of these.
Thank you.
How is it?
It's so good. This place makes you feel like yourself, doesn't it?
Really does. Maybe it's because myself is fresh fruit, spicy food, fresh coconuts, sea swimming, and tropical vibes, and very fun and friendly people.
Oh yeah! Yeah. Happy, happy, yeah!
Well, I really needed that after that sea swim.
Coconuts have an enzyme in them which makes up the flesh, and then the rest is the water.
Josh is a big foodie and always up for anything new. So Thai taste tickled his taste buds.
The name of this one?
Abalone.
Abalone. What is it?
You know, you've seen the lighting, haven't you?
But not everyone was quite so keen to get involved. But would you try these insect snacks?
Will you have one?
No, I'm not having one.
Wow, scorpion. Oh my goodness. Would you try one? A scorpion? No? Oh, come on.
Alaika.
Alaika.
There were many food firsts that wouldn't be on your standard Mediterranean menu.
Josh, that's the main ingredient, chicken nuggets.
Well, I don't eat them. Mother of all donuts about to go down the hatch. How is it?
Yum.
Oh my God. That looks amazing. It also looks like something that's going to keep you up all night. Awesome. Thanks for me.
So we're in Kamala at the minute. Just stopped at the Green Pancake. It's Valentine's Day. We're going to treat the boys and Laura's going to have some of mine, I think.
So Ross has been out and got us all pancakes.
Gone for banana. Thought I'd go healthy, you know.
Classic.
Noah's gone for even healthier. Peanut butter. And Josh has got
mango, chocolate, and
condensed milk.
Oh yeah.
That's the added touch.
And this is the card I managed to get Ross. It's a thank you card. I couldn't find anything else, but it has got a blue butterfly on it. Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
What's up? Yum.
On camera.
And of course, it would be out of character for us not to pay a visit to an Irish bar.
I live down the road from Buddy's barroom. I got a running tab, it's done run away.
Oh, he's a happy man. Got to do my thing though.
Sometimes I think I'm whistling past the graveyard. Last night I got so drunk, I didn't even know my name. But the beer is cold and the music's always playing. And the jukebox is the best there is in town. Take you free at a happy hour. Country songs and whiskey sours can cheer up any man who's feeling down.
Amazing. Noah's going to be happy.
Oh, it looks good.
This one will be not going
on. Getting the full English, are you?
Oh, yeah.
Nice if Holly was anchored out there, wouldn't it? Noah, would you help me get Holly Blue to Thailand? Or would you fly?
You know what? When we get home, we should start doing that. Mate, actually, just need you to get to Thailand.
What do you think, Josh? Would you want to be with me and Noah or go with Mummy on the plane?
I got Mummy on the plane because she'll be falling apart without any of that.
Eating out is close to the top of the list of things we enjoy together, and Thailand truly delivers in every way, shape and form. From beachside breakfasts...
I'm very excited about this. I did not know it was going to come with mint.
No. To roadside dinners...
getting a takeaway tonight.
Markets.
We're at the Thai markets and Ross is going for the healthy version tonight.
And special experiences never to be forgotten.
So cold.
If you're visiting Phuket as a family, there are heaps of things for the kids to do, from parks and attractions in Kamala to kids' centres like Rawai Park, a hidden gem with an indoor play centre, an outdoor splash pool, and restaurant.
Oh, thanks. Shouldn't have.
Standard. I'm absolutely bricking it.
And she's limping.
Have you told them where we're going yet?
We're going to the Big Buddha, which is high. That's what Laura's stressing about.
I really do not like going uphill on bikes. Me and bikes, I love them, but at the same time I hate them.
She's better after a sang song.
Ready, Josh?
Always am.
Born that way.
You're leading the way, are you?
Yep, 25 minutes, all uphill.
Big Buddha stands at a whopping 148 feet tall and 83.5 feet wide, covered from head to toe in Burmese white marble. It was constructed to symbolise the harmonious relationship between man, nature, people and faith. As the Phuket Big Buddha is a religious site, just remember it's considered disrespectful to arrive in beachwear.
Oh dear.
Do you think I'll pass?
I don't know, it's the most clothes I've seen on you for a while.
As long as you get there before the masses descend and you get up close to Big Buddha itself, the atmosphere is very peaceful. The the only sounds to be heard are the tinkling of small bells, the fluttering of yellow Buddhist flags, and soft background Dharma music playing. Historically, Buddha was born as the son of a king, but decided to renounce his luxurious life to become a perfectly enlightened being who has achieved the highest knowledge of truth. The teaching of Buddha was to want for nothing, to avoid all evil, to do good, and to purify one's mind, all in order to bring about harmony and happiness in their lives. As a sailing family, in many ways, we can personally relate to Buddha's story. Once upon a time, we sacrificed our own creature comforts and complicated consumerist ways to find a new, more simple life of enlightenment. Love this morning light. It's gorgeous. Well, we've had a wonderful time here in Kamala, and now we've got to go. But I think it's time to get a bit more ocean bound, as we've had a few weeks of land life and miss the sea. Want to be on it, not in front of it. Thanks for watching, guys. We really hope you've enjoyed our recent travels to Asia. Please join us in our next episode where we're back in Greece. It's time to get back behind the stern and Holly Blue once again spreads her wings to fly.
Is the sky like the color of your eyes? Blue is your heart. It's been like that from the start. Say you'll stay till the morning light. I'll help you through the fight. Let's make footprints.